Back here in Hartsville, South Carolina, what a comeback for the Bulldogs. Trailed multiple times there late in regulation and overtime. Somehow found a way to win. Joining us now, Wingate head coach Ann Hancock after a 54-52 overtime victory. Wow, coach, another poor shooting night for this team. Just couldn't find ways to score. The zone gave you all kind of problems, but somehow found a way to win. The hustle plays really got it done. Kayla's offensive rebound put back to send the game in overtime. And then Amber Steele, take me back to that last possession. Defensively, they were just going to play it out. She had timeouts, wanted to play it out offensively, get the steal. It looked like Janisha was off and running, but they got the timeout. Talking about the play there, and Amber just made something out of really nothing there that last 4 seconds.
Basically, yeah, you got it right. You know, I think there were 3.9 seconds left, and they're in zone, so it makes it really, really hard to try and drive. But the way they're playing the zone, they're picking up the point guard in the backcourt almost like man-to-man. So we're going to try to maybe let Kayla set her screen, and we said, if you can take it all the way to the basket, you go. If not, maybe throw it back behind to Janisha. And before the game, we talked about the pregame talk was really about this time of year, great teams find a way to finish plays, find a way to finish games, and find a way to finish the season. And we didn't have any quit tonight because a couple of times it looked sort of bleak and we got a loose ball or a deflection, a steal, and then to send it into overtime. And if Kayla hadn't followed that shot, you know, it wouldn't have ended up this way. So proud of the girls, proud of the effort, and hopefully we can find a way to score against zone because we're going to see some more of it,
I'm sure. Yeah, I was going to ask you about it. Hit two of your first four threes, then end the game with 14 straight misses, but got some good looks. You know, when you go back and look at it, will you be disappointed with just a miss, or do you want to try to find a way to get Kayla the ball? Because it felt like in overtime, she just decided, I'm going to take it at the elbow and take it right to the rack.
Getting it to Kayla is always a good option.
Yeah.
Again, if we can make a couple of those, it makes it easier to do that. But if you're not making it, it makes it really hard. But there at the end, let's get her at least a touch to try and see what she can do. And, you know, I'm looking at the stats, and she had 25 and 14, and it didn't seem like it. It just seemed like we really could not score the ball at all. So, you know, the last basket was really dramatic, and that's what everybody will remember. But Kayla did have a great performance.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about Kayla. She seemed like a player that has been in moments like this in her life and just did not want to let her team lose. Looked very tense during her couple foul shots there, but had a good smile there. But, Coach, in a game where Janisha goes 2 of 15, Shelby 1 of 9, Amber 2 of 7, Kayla goes 10 of 17, 25 and 14, and none of them were easy. I mean, what does it say about this, her to really feel this pride in the blue and gold, even though she's only worn it for about 8 months?
Well, we feel like she's been here for a long time, and hopefully she feels the same way, that this is, you know, her school now. And, you know, we'll keep trying to ride her all the way to the end of that. But she's a great girl, and I think she's really made a difference in our program as far as competitiveness. You know, she was coming off a knee injury, and we didn't really know how she would recover from that. But even off of a knee injury, she never took that as an excuse to not go hard, to not do any preseason conditioning. She was right in the mix with that, and I think that has really paid off for us as a group to see how hard she really does work. And that's a good thing when one of your best players is your hardest worker.
Well, Coach, it's no secret, but a three-point win at Carson Newman, barely got by at Queens and skate tonight. All those games, the points in the 50s. This is a great scoring team, 70 points a game. Better than that at home. You get to go home for two in a row where you're trying to get that cutting magic going again, where you've won 8 straight conference games and just kind of say, all right, it was a tough road trip, but, hey, we won 3. We're still in first. Let's go finish what we've started this season.
Absolutely. You know, it'll be nice to be back home, but we found a little bit of magic on the road lately, so hopefully we can keep it going.
Coach, thanks for your time. Wow.
Yeah.
What a win. What a win. 54-52 in overtime.
Thanks, Ryan.